Hello everyone. Today we will start with a very common operation used in several applications, that is sorting. There are various algorithms which are available to perform sorting. We are going to look at a few popular ones in this session. Sorting is defined as arranging the given input sequence in non-increasing or non-decreasing order. We will start with algorithms having n square time complexity, namely bubble sort, selection sort, and insertion sort. Then we discuss two important as well as popular n log n complexity algorithms. They are quick sort and merge sort algorithms. Lastly, we discuss linear time complexity algorithms, that is counting sort, radix sort, and bucket sort. As far as shell sort is considered, then its complexity varies in between n and n square. We will discuss each of these algorithms one by one in separate sessions. There are a few things which are required to be discussed, and they are in place, stable, and online. By in place sorting algorithm, we mean if an algorithm is using the same space to store the output where the input sequence was stored by means of overwriting, then the algorithm is known as in-place sorting algorithm. By stable sorting algorithm, we mean if the relative ordering of elements having same key values remains same before and after the execution of sorting algorithm, then the algorithm is said to be stable, as it maintains the relative ordering even after the completion of the sorting process. For example, in the given sequence, we have the element 10 appearing 3 times. If the sorting algorithm is stable, then the sequence in which the 3 tens are appearing, it will remain same even after the execution of the sorting algorithm. That means the 10 marked as red, it will appear the first, then comes the 10 marked with color green, followed by the last 10. If the algorithm is maintaining this relative ordering, then comes in the category of stable sorting algorithm. If the sequence of these tens it varies, then the corresponding algorithm does not fall in the category of stable sorting algorithm. Then there is a concept of online algorithm. If the complete sequence to be sorted is not required to be known beforehand, then the algorithm falls in the category of online, else not. That means if we are working only with a part of the array and then we will look at the rest of the array elements as they come, then the sorting algorithm is said to be an online algorithm. On the other hand, if we need the complete information of the array to be sorted in advance, that means before the start of the execution of the sorting algorithm, then that algorithm is not online. That's all for now. Thank you.